Hello, I am Liana. Welcome to my channel. If you've found me from this video or maybe my previous video, I am a rising college freshman that is going to attend VCU Arts in the fall. And I really wanted to make this video because I think it would have helped me when I was applying for VCU Arts. About tips on your portfolio. I did not take a single art class when I was in high school, and I didn't really have that type of guidance in my high school career, so I thought that this would be a good video to have for people that maybe are in my position or maybe took art all throughout high school and know they want to go to art school. I didn't know I wanted to go to art school, and it was really late when I decided to apply, so I think these tips really would have helped me. I have 5 tips for when you are making your application for art school. Tip number 1, don't strive to be perfect, strive to do your best. I know it's really, really easy to nitpick your details in every single piece that you do and try to fix every little detail, but you're always going to have weak spots and you can't fix everything because there's always going to be something that you can change. You really have to focus on the whole piece, your whole portfolio, how that fits together, rather than focusing on if you use the right shade of green or not. Just try your best, as cheesy as it sounds, and it will really show. Tip number 2, use your resources. What I mean by this is, some way or another, there are people around you that can help and will want to help you make your portfolio the best it can be. If you feel the need to, get feedback. Take the advice from others that are offering it. I personally know someone that is in the VCU Arts program already, and I asked her for advice when I was doing mine, and she gave me great advice that has made it into these tips. I definitely would have not had a strong portfolio if not for her advice. I also have friends that are just people that like to help me or are experienced with art, and so I asked them for help and they helped me figure out what order I should put my portfolio in, or editing my additional detail section, or editing my photos. Even if you don't know anyone personally, or your friends or your family maybe don't, even if there aren't people around you that don't want to help, there are so many people on the internet that do want to help. Tip number 3, focus on what you're best at, but if you want to experiment, do that too. In your college application, not just your art portfolio, you have to put an emphasis on the things that are your strong suits, because you have to try to stand out. In your portfolio, choose mediums that you work the best with. Personally, I'm the best with 3D art. I use a lot of clay, I use wire, and that's what I really put a focus on in my portfolio. I made sure to include a lot of my 3D art at the beginning of my portfolio and at the end of my portfolio, so those were the things that they would remember from my portfolio after they've looked at it. I wanted to give them a lasting impression of my abilities and what I can do. I also did a ton of experimentation when I was building my portfolio. I started drawing again. I started painting. I did a lot of things that were out of my comfort zone, out of the normal realm of things that I do, and I actually included some sketches and a couple paintings that I ended up doing. And if I hadn't experimented, my portfolio would have been a lot less diverse than it ended up being. You do not have to have a diverse portfolio. You can use one medium throughout your whole portfolio and it can be super strong. But I knew that I really wanted to show that I have the capabilities of doing other things than just 3D art, which is what I'm best at. I also did not include everything that I made during this process that I experimented with. There were things that did not turn out the way that I wanted them to, and I just scrapped them. I only included the things that I thought were my best work and that I was proud of. Tip number 4. Spend time crafting the additional detail section. If you haven't done a portfolio before, you would not know what this is. I did not know what this is. I did not know anything about what the format of the portfolio was going to look like until I started it. For other art schools, it might be different, but for VCU Arts, they use Slideroom for your portfolio. There's a place in your portfolio that you can put about 1,000 words of information on each of your pieces that you think is valuable for the admissions office to see. I was offered advice that you should really use this section and treat it as the second part of your portfolio. You can have a wonderful portfolio without using the additional detail section, but it really gives you a leg up if you take time to craft paragraphs that are really informative about your pieces. Do not explain what your piece is. Explain how your piece came to be. You have to remember this. They can see the image of your piece. They know what it looks like. And you're gonna list the mediums and the dimensions. You really should tell the admissions office how you came up with the idea and how your process went, and maybe, or some mistakes that you made while making this piece and how you use those mistakes to make the piece better. They want to know the journey, they don't want to know the destination. Tip number 5. Be proud of every piece you create in your portfolio. Do not include pieces that you are not proud of. It sounds really silly, but it's true. If you're just unsure about how you feel about the piece or how it fits into your portfolio, I would suggest just not putting it in. It's okay if you don't use all of the spaces that you're given for your portfolio. VCU Arts gives you 16 spaces to put 16 pieces of art. I ended up using 14 out of 16 of those spaces. Two of those spaces were one art piece that I just zoomed in on, and that's totally okay. I really went into the portfolio process thinking that I had to use all those 16 spaces, but I realized that it's really quality over quantity. Please do not try to fill up those spaces because you think that they should see more of your work. They really only need to see the work that you put your best effort into. That's it! I hope that this advice is helpful. If you have any questions, you can DM my Instagram or you can leave them in the comments down below and I will definitely answer them. And thank you so much for taking time to watch this video. If you enjoyed it, you should subscribe. I do quite a bit of art stuff, and I will be making videos about my art college journey. So if you would like to see that, stick around. And I hope you have a wonderful morning, evening, afternoon, whatever.